Hey, so this is the Flipper Zero that I got. It's got GPIO and I2C ports and stuff on the top. The firmware is open source, so you can play with it. It's got a little game that as you use it, your levels increase. It's got an infrared transmitter and receiver and one wire, iButton type stuff there. So yeah, you can say like infrared, universal remote for a television. And it just sent the codes for the TV. So the TV's on now. You can send a channel switch, that kind of stuff. So that's how the infrared remote works. And then again, it's open firmware, so you can add other remotes if it didn't have that in the catalog. The GPIO, most of the demos for this is like output type stuff, so you can output on a given pin. And when you press the button, the little light turns on and the pin goes high. The iButton, you can do a read. I don't actually have an iButton, but I have a Java ring from the Forever Java 1 conference. And so we just read it, and it's not a key, but that's the ID of the device. So if it was a key, the beginning code would be different. But it read this ID, and then you could go in and say more, and now you could emulate it. And if something else was just looking at the ID of the device, it would look the same. So that's what that is. But I think one of the more really interesting things that I've been using is this sub gigahertz, and so I'll probably do a series of videos on that. And so the way this works really well is there's a frequency analyzer, and so you can just go ahead and run the frequency analyzer and then take whatever device you have that's sending out a thing, press the button. And so now we know that this device is running right around 310 megahertz. Okay, the house is running at 433.92, that kind of stuff. So that's pretty cool. So once you know that, you can shoot. I have to go back inside. Evidently, it's too bright out there. Once you know that, you can do a read. And if it knows the protocol, you can go back and configure which frequency, like we were just saying. Here's 310. So now it's scanning at 310. And then if it knows the protocol, so I added the firmware that actually knows about this device now. So let's go ahead and press button that we're on EF, and we'll press button 3 on the on. And so that's the code from the X10 device. So you can see that this is a x10.com at the bottom there. And then go ahead and click into it to get the details. So we pressed button 3, sent it on, and we were on the channel F on there. So now you know when you receive that signal, and this can get from like the next room over, you'll know exactly what channel they were on and what button they pressed. And then you could do a replay with one of these devices. But another really cool trick is you can actually go and say read raw and then configure it for the frequency you care about. So 310. And then if you want, you can kind of set a dB threshold and go ahead and hit record and then press the button you want. And then stop. And then you can go ahead and save that signal to recall later, or you can just replay that signal. And so now without the remote, we're able to play that. So that's pretty cool. So let's go ahead and exit that. And I'm gonna go ahead and go into my saved. And so I have on here, let's see, the X10 on. So we'll go ahead and load that so you can see the lights. Oh, the lights are already on. So let me go to X10 off. So right now you can see that the lights are on and I just sent a signal to turn them off. So that was pretty awesome. So anything that does non-rolling codes in a bunch of frequencies, you're able to figure out what frequency it is and then record it and then play it back. And I'm kind of surprised how many things do non-rolling codes. So then the last one, I haven't had a chance to actually try it yet, but I wanted to, which is to go ahead and try to see what happens if we play this signal. It's a little windy. I don't know where the fuse is going to go if it works, but let's try it. It looks like it didn't. My device. You can see that on here the device is lighting for channel one, but it looks like my fuse is bad, unfortunately. Oh, it's, I see now, yeah, it's blinking on the thing, so I need to put in new batteries. But anyway, maybe I'll make another video of lighting off the fireworks using the flipper.